Oaks Wisteria.
Moon here, and today I'm going to be doing a snazzy little Animal Jam Play Wild update video for all of you because the Play Wild update was actually just released today, even though it was supposed to be released, I think, Wednesday of this week, and it is now Friday, but, you know, I guess this time Animal Jam themselves are late to the party, which makes me feel slightly better about myself because there was definitely no way that I was getting an update video out on Wednesday. So anyways, without further ado, let us hop straight into the video. I hear that there's a lot of juicy content on the way, so I'm going to be clicking on the Jamaa Journal within the Jamaa Township, checking out all this jazzy new content. So on the first page, we have llamas are here. Woo! Guys, I had no idea that Play Wild was going to be releasing a brand new animal. So this is some pretty intense stuff. I am definitely going to be obtaining this llama. I'm assuming that it is, as always, in a bundle, so I cannot wait to get my hands on that. Now, the one thing I'm going to add to this is that llamas are already available in the desktop version of Animal Jam. So that kind of gives us some insight as to how they might look on Play Wild. They're probably going to be small, dainty little creatures, and I'm very excited for that. So now on the next page, we have pet honeybees.
Oh!
So apparently these pet honeybees are being released in celebration of National Honeybee Day, which is on August 18th. Wow, the more you know. Now, I don't know if pet honeybees have already been released in Play Wild or if this is the first time they're making an appearance, but bees have traditionally been seasonally released on the desktop version of Animal Jam for a little while now. So this is essentially a continuing trend, and I'm very excited to get my hands on these pet honeybees. They look absolutely adorable. And then on the next page, we have Pack Run's Shell Stravaganza. So apparently we have a new Pack Run theme available. Up until this point, I was not entirely certain on how Pack Runs work because they first started with forest runs where you had to collect a certain number of fireflies, then it turned into beetles. So now apparently this little makeshift Play Wild version of the adventures is now beach themed, and apparently we have to collect as many shells as possible and rank up on the leaderboards, which I think is pretty interesting. I am a huge lover of the Pack Runs, but I don't think I'm going to be getting to that in this video, but possibly in a later Play Wild video. So on the next page, we have something that looks very similar to the Animal Jam update, actually. It actually seems as though these images are interchangeable. I just did an update video going over the Animal Jam desktop updates yesterday, so yeah, I would know. To the left, we have an announcement of the Schoolhouse Party, which again mimics the Animal Jam update, but apparently we have this party available in Play Wild too, which is pretty nifty. And then we have a little back to school announcement, which pretty much announces that there are going to be some new item releases under the theme of back to school, which, you know, it's probably my least favorite theme that these games have come out with as of yet, but that's just because I hate going back to school. Who doesn't? So then on the next page, we have the snazzy llama bundle. Wow, I feel pretty accomplished right now. Animal Jam's jumping on that snazzy bandwagon. But anyways, apparently this bundle contains a special hairdresser outfit and a set of hairstyles. So I am particularly intrigued to see what this bundle has in store because this seems to be quite the difference from the typical bundles, which usually just include strange outfit collections, but nothing as versatile as hairstyles. So I'm psyched for that. And then on the next page, we have a new game, Pest Control. I'm pretty sure that this game already exists in the desktop version of Animal Jam, but feel free to correct me if I'm wrong. That seems to be some pretty fun stuff, but I don't think I'm going to be playing this in this video because I already have so much new content to review. So heading on over to the next page, we have awesome AR fun. So Play Wild actually introduced this AR feature quite a while ago. As you can see under the settings tab in the top right corner, there is a little AR button, and if you click it, your phone's back camera will actually turn on and you will be able to drag certain 3D elements from Play Wild, such as animals and now apparently den items, onto your screen so that it appears like these items are actually integrated with your real life surroundings. And apparently this only works for Apple devices. So it is a bit unfortunate for Android users. I know that a lot of people using this app are probably Android users, but let me know in the comments if you'd like me to do a second AR review video because I've already done one, but it was kind of limited. So I'm interested to see what these updates contain. But again, that is something to save for a later date. So now on the next page, we have paint with the Apple Pencil. And this is kind of one of the weirder advertisements I've ever seen Play Wild do, because this is actually not an advertisement for any kind of Animal Jam related feature. It is an advertisement for the Apple Pencil. Now, just for the record, I actually do happen to have an Apple Pencil and it works pretty stunningly, and I'm sure it would be very convenient in creating masterpieces on Play Wild, but again, it is kind of strange. I wonder if Apple somehow sponsored this advertisement, but that's really interesting. I did not know that Animal Jam did sponsored ads, so I don't know how to feel about that. I mean, I guess there's nothing inherently inherently wrong with it, but I just figured it was against their policies. So yeah, I don't know. That's interesting. And then on the next page, we have another advertisement, which makes more sense. This is the same advertisement that was put in the desktop Animal Jam update, which is an advertisement for the latest edition of the Animal Jam box. I've already done an unboxing and review video of this because I typically get sent Animal Jam boxes when they come out. And I'll pop that up on the screen right now, but you can also find it on my channel. I'll also link it in the description below if you would like to watch the unboxing of this Animal Jam box so that you can see for yourselves what's inside of it and whether or not it's worth buying. So now we're getting back into some old updates. This I don't really count as an update because it was just a release of some new armor sets, and that was released last week. But then the updates of the week before that, I've already made a whole video covering. So without further ado, I'm going to be heading on over to the Sapphire shop and purchasing this brand new llama bundle and reviewing the outfits for you all, because that seems to be the most logical procedure. Also, just a quick note, Playwild actually changed their loading screen. Personally, I honestly think I liked the old one better because there was a little bit more going on and I just enjoyed that format, but I guess updates are nice, change is good. This one isn't terrible. It looks clean and fresh, so that's nice. So anyways, if we click this little board back here, we will be taken to our various bundle options. I've already purchased the Gallant Giraffe bundle and the Safari Manor bundle, so let us pick up our snazzy llama bundle. This bundle actually saves us apparently 55 sapphires, because since you're buying the whole bundle, they kind of discount it from what it would cost to just buy the animal and outfit straight up. So let us go ahead and make this purchase. So here we have our llama, which again looks very similar to the desktop llama. Maybe the fur pattern is slightly different, but yeah, it looks pretty much exactly how I'd expect it to look, but nevertheless very adorable. And here is some wavy hair, which does not look the most fashionable, but you know, we'll go with it. A scissor necklace, which sounds absolutely terrifying to be honest. A hairstylist apron, fully equipped with a hair dryer. Hair tie bracelets, which look pretty adorable. A broom tail. I don't even know what to necessarily say about this. That's a little out there for my taste. Then we've got some chunky braids, which seems like it would go really well with certain outfits, but I don't know, you'd probably have to wear it in the right context. And oh, got some feathered hair. This sort of looks like my hair when it was brown, except I didn't have bangs, so that's pretty cute. Also got this crazy hair. I really wish that Playwild kind of invested their resources in making hairstyles that were more realistic, because I don't really think that crazy hair, like, yeah, this is even worse. No one has hair like this. Like, come on. I want more usable hairstyles. But yeah, see, this is a more usable one. I approve of it. Hopefully it looks good on the actual animal. And now we are being switched to our llama dude. Luckily, I think my den has still been locked. I'm going to be unlocking it actually after this video is done being recorded, but it is nice to have my den locked up while I'm recording update videos, just because things get a little laggy on this app. And yeah, it kind of helps to do this type of content in a solo fashion. But anyways, here's a close-up look of our brand new llama. It has a very spiffy little trot, and I feel like the animation on this is just very clean and nicely done. I approve of it. I also like the default look to it, the color pattern and everything. It's cute. So let's see what this dancing is like. Oh, we've got like a very trotty little, almost Irish step dance looking maneuver. It's giving those legs a good old kick. It's very spunky. It almost looks like it's pogo sticking, but also step dancing. I don't know. That's a lot of craziness right there. Now this is our play action, and I have no idea what the heck is going on here. I literally don't know what that's supposed to be, but I think I just enjoy the floppiness of the ears. That is some thrilling stuff. Next, we got a dainty little hop. Llama's not the most skilled jumper, but it really gives it its all. Like, it's really trying hard. I commend that. Then we've got a cute little sit. It almost has given me some bunny vibes here with that little puffy tail. And last but not least, the sleep, which again looks pretty adorable. It's kind of like it's sitting, but it's got its little floopy ears curved over. I think that is some precious stuff. So now I'm actually going to be trying on some of these latest outfits. I'm not really going to be changing my look at the moment because I want to give myself a chance to try all the rest of the items in this bundle on first. So let's start with the hairdresser set. First, you get this wavy hair, and then we've got our scissor necklace, terrifying, our apron, our bracelets, and our broom tail. I feel about this outfit the way I've been feeling about pretty much all of Playwild's recent bundle outfits. It's kind of random, weird, doesn't really make sense, and it's cool because we've got like stuff coming out of the outfit. I guess this is like hairspray and perfume and stuff. So like, that's cool. It's always cool to see what little animations occur when you buy a complete outfit set from these bundles or from the Sapphire shop in general. But like, this is just absurd. Like, I don't really know what context you're going to need this in except for a salon roleplay. And even then, I'm not even sure if you'd want to wear this. But maybe some of these outfit items are usable on their own. Like, the little bracelet anklet things are not too terrible on their own. It's just I'm not really digging this apron or the broom tail or the wig, really. The wig is a little extra. You know, it does look a little Melanie Martinez-esque, though, I have to say. Anyways, let's give these other hairstyles a quick try. So, okay then. That did not turn out how I expected. Okay, whose idea was this? They literally chose to put the llama's fluff on top of the hair, which just doesn't even make logistical sense. Anyways, this is kind of looking like some kind of crazed pop star caught off guard by paparazzis. Either that or like a 35-year-old mom. I don't know, that hair. Not a fan. Not as much of a fan as I thought I would be, but maybe it'll look better on another animal. This hair, yep, this came out pretty much exactly like I was expecting it to, which is terrible. We kind of look like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, maybe, or I don't know. I feel like there's another character I should be comparing this to, but I can't think of it right now. I mean, I guess it's kind of Surfer Dude, but it also kind of bothers me when Surfer Dude hair is drawn like this because it looks like literal French fries. And like, no one's hair looks like that. I should be less critical. I kind of need to chill. It's just for fun. But like, come on. If they're gonna come out with hair, I want it to be usable hair, you know, because hair is a very underappreciated feature on Animal Jam. Anyways, this, you know, maybe I can live with this. I feel like you can make a pretty good villain look with this. Maybe some Jack Frost cosplay. I don't know. I guess there is something that you could gain from this. It almost looks like a human, honestly. But I think the reason I'm digging this one, even though the hairstyle is intrinsically strange, is just because there's no llama fluff puffing out of the top. So yeah, I think that actually fits reasonably well. Now, this is the one that they're disappointing me on the most, because I had the highest expectations for this hair, and it just looks dreadful. This is definitely the worst out of all of them, because not only does the llama fluff poke out the top, but like, it doesn't even fully poke out the top. So it's just like this small gap right where the middle of the bang should be. So that is disturbing and looks very ugly. And I don't even want to draw comparisons to what this might look like, because it doesn't even look like anything close to reality. Like, I've never seen a human being or a character this kind of hair. So moving on to the next hairstyle, I've probably been way too critical of this update. I probably need to take it down a notch, but yeah. Oh lordy, it gets worse. It gets way worse. I feel like these braids might have actually been really cute, but again, we just got this weird tuft and it's just very, very out of place. I cannot take this look seriously at all. It's almost looking Egyptian right now. I don't know, guys. This bundle set is just a trip, you know? I know that I really need to take the criticism down a notch, but like, I just feel like Play Wild does a really good job of releasing new content, but sometimes they just don't put their full effort in and they rush things. And I think that the hairstyles don't really fit the llama that well. And that's a problem, because when you buy this bundle, you expect to be wearing these outfits on the new animal that they come with. So like, I don't know. That's just my opinion, but feel free to let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I'm open to hearing your thoughts as well. I'm sorry if I'm being overly critical. I do think that the bundle set is still probably worth the sapphires, because they're the most economical way to purchase a new animal. And these hairstyles might actually look decent on other animals. I just don't really feel like trying it on right now, because this video's already definitely been quite lengthy. So real quick, I am actually going to be claiming my daily chest prize from a llama animal specifically, just because I want to see if there are any unique item potentials. So let's click on these chests. And oh, it appears that I actually did win the treasure hunt item. So let's go pop this in the den real quick. So yeah, I'm not entirely sure about this, but I'm pretty sure that each animal within the daily chest provides a different set of items that you can win, or at least there are some unique preferences to them. So, oh, actually, as it turns out, it was not a den item. It was actually a clothing item. So I'm curious about this. Oh, okay. I see how this works now. We have a Peruvian knit hat, and that is some very colorful stuff. You know what? In a weird way, I don't actually hate it. I know my taste is very inconsistent, but like, look at that coloration. Look at how much effort they put into that pattern and detailing. Like, that is actually pretty impressive. Like, it's definitely a weird item, but like, it really fits the llama perfectly, and it's just kind of cool. Like, I don't know, I just really dig that aesthetic. So yeah, if you're going to get the llama, make sure that you hit up that chest for the chance to win this Peruvian hat and maybe other various llama themed items. I'm pretty glad I did that, and I'm glad I actually happened to have won the item. I mean, I was feeling lucky, but I wasn't sure I was gonna win it, so that's exciting. Anyways, I'm going to be heading back into the Jamaa Township real quick and heading on over to the Sapphire Shop so that we may go ahead and adopt ourselves a little pet bee, which I'm super excited for because pet bees are adorable. So let us head on over to this little pets table over here and click on the pet honeybee. Now, this is actually something that I was not expecting, but am very, very excited for. The pet honeybee is actually available for gems, so you don't even need sapphires to purchase this. And that's pretty great, because that means you could just basically play a bunch of Play Wild games or pack runs and buy yourself the pet honeybee rather than having to wait to earn the sapphires. So yes, let's go ahead and snazz out our little honeybee. I feel like it's not a real authentic bee unless it has a yellow stripe. So I'm going to be sticking with that, but I'm going to make the outsides of it white because why not? I think it's pretty fun. You can also change the eyes. And this just looks hilarious, to be honest, because this bee has way more of a face than actual honeybees do. But yeah, it's still pretty cute. I think I'm going to go with probably these eyes. I mean, they look a little terrifying, but like kind of cute. So yeah, we'll stick with that. And we'll make them bold colored. I think that's some pretty cute stuff. Unfortunately, we don't have really any other customization options since it is Play Wild. We can really only change our colors and eyes, but that's okay. We can live with it. So let's name this guy Gold Guy, because how much more perfect could it get than Gold Guy? This certifies that Gold Guy was adopted on Friday, August 3rd, 2018. Amazing. Now, the favorite food. I have so many questions. Why would it not be honey? Why in the heck would it be zucchini? Okay, you know what? Never mind. Just never mind. You know, everything else in here relates to bees. You know, favorite toy, beehive. Personality, wild, brave, strong. Breed, honeybee. Favorite food, zucchini. Okay. I'm so done. I tried to ignore it, but I can't. That is just the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen in my life. So in Play Wild, there isn't a pet stop, which is kind of interesting. On Play Wild, you actually just straight up buy clothing items and they're interchangeable between all of your different pets. So I'm going to see if we have any cute bee themed items in here, but if not, I'm not going to bother. Yeah, that Jamon journal was a little bit misleading because there are no bee themed pet items in here and I can't really think of anything else that I want to put on this bee. Actually, I take it back. This. I don't know why, but it was just calling to me. There we go. Perfect. We've got ourselves a little bee bear. That is some adorable stuff. I'm gonna cry. Wow, I'm just looking like a character right now. I'm like a llama with a weird sombrero carrying around a pet bee that's wearing a bear hat. This is just some fascinating stuff. But at least we're like kind of on a matching color scheme, so that's pretty rad. But anyways, folks, even though this Play Wild update has a lot of other new features that I haven't been able to review, I'm probably going to be covering them in future videos, so stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, I really hope that you all enjoyed watching this Play Wild update. Please be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I personally enjoyed it a lot. I mean, I think I pretty much gave a fair overview of my thoughts on the new llama and the bee, but in terms of the update as a whole, I thought it was pretty great because there was just a lot of new content, a lot of new features. There's like a whole new pack run, a new AR feature. There's just tons and tons of stuff available and a new animal and pet. Like, how much more exciting does it get than that? So anyways, folks, again, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'd really like to hear your opinions on this update. And with that, as always, thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.